Hey everyone, so this is Blaze. Welcome to another episode of Pirate 101. We are in the fabulous Mushu, continuing on our quest to defeat everyone, defeat all the generals, and, I don't know, save the good people. What are you? You look like a sheep? The good sheep people and goat people of Mushu. So, we are currently in Hamamitsu, and we're looking to upgrade our ship again, because I am level 48 for our nautical level, and 47 for our actual level. And I think at level 48 we could buy a new pirate ship, so let's see. What do we have here? Level 48 only. Nope, never mind. It's not nautical level 48, it is actually level 48. So we can buy that once we get, like, 2600 more XP. So that is our next goal, is to upgrade that, to get that. Basically the best ship that Mushu offers, I think, from what I've seen. So we need to go talk to the governor and get our Inoshishi staff and pick up our, well, hopefully our 5,000 XP. Oh, there's more side quests here? Wonder how many more side quests are here. I don't know. But yeah, last time we defeated General So in his little hut, which actually was a long dungeon. And people in the comments reminded me that in later worlds there's even longer dungeons than that. So yeah, looking forward. Okay. Here's the governor, let's see what he has to say.
What business brings you here?
Okay, we got our 5,000. And our staff.
So you say that the Armada seeks to translate the markings upon the piece of Marco Polo's map? To do so, they must consult the Scroll of Secrets, the only copy of which is held in the Library of Contemplation in Tsubata. In return for the aid you have given Mushu, I grant you free passage into Tsubata, so that you might pursue your foe. I suggest you speak to Lord Chagatai in Tsubata Temple. Tell him I sent you, and he will assist you in your quest.
Okay, so basically, last time, I said that we were possibly done with Mushu because the dialogue made it seem like that, but obviously I knew that there was an extra skyway called Tsubata Skyway, so I think really we're done with two skyways, and there's three in Mushu, but people said that Tsubata takes the longest. Or maybe it's not just Tsubata that's long, but maybe it makes you go back to other ones. I don't know. We'll just have to see. But yeah, we're making some progress through Mushu. So we are level 48. Let's see here. We're level 48. So that means we can buy that pirate ship. What is that? Let's see if we can buy this now. Yeah. The galleon. What is our current? Oh, it's basically just a better galleon, but look at that. It's increased the level by 8 of the pirate ship. So, might as well buy it. How much is it? 44,000. I know that we said once I hit like 150k, we were going to buy that house. Well, looks like we're investing in a pirate ship. You can actually pick the colors, but I'm perfectly fine with the green that it has already. So, bye. Happy Panda. Happy Panda. Our last ship was Happy Garden, now we're Happy Panda. I like this trend of our pirate ships, that's pretty good. Okay, we need to equip this. Actually, we need to unequip everything that's on our current one. Unequip. Goodbye, swan. Is that a swan? It's a heron. Okay, it's not a swan. Where is our new one? Here it is, Happy Panda. Galleon Beast, let's see what it looks like without anything on it. There it is. But we're going to make it look even better by adding some amazing stuff. Add this and this. It's a Mushu ship, so I can just use everything that I already have on it again. Basically, like, recycle. Which one was better? Engineer's wheel. Yeah. And this. Okay, that should be it. We put the cannons on, right? Yep. Alright, there is our new one. Doesn't look that different, but in the long run, it's way better because of its stats. So, yeah, while we head over to Tsubata, I have some other stuff that we can look at. On the way over, let's see, how far away is Tsubata Skyway? Do we have to go through the other one to get there? No, we can go straight there. Okay, it's not that far. So, yeah, basically, let's check out our companions. We got Lebo. I gave him some talents. He has Overwatch and Double Tap. So there's that. Level 49. I was trying him out a little bit. He does a good amount of damage. So probably because he's like a lot higher. You know what we should do is level up Campo and El Toro. Oh my gosh, it's like snowy here. That's cool. It's like really green over here, kind of dead over there, snowy over here, and it's like fall slash autumn over there. Okay, we're going the wrong way. We have to go in here. So when we land here, we're going to check out some of the stuff. We're going to train up our companions and get that sorted. Okay. This place looks awesome. Let's see. Campo, we can get him to level 45. I do know that Campo, once he hits level 49, he gets another promotion. Promotion number 2. Back in Cool Ranch, we got him up to Goat Disciple, so we'll just have to wait and see what the next one is. El Toro up to 45. I have so many training points, but we're going to level up the other people. Level up you. I'm going to give them all their talents later. Oh my gosh, he's only level 30. Your companion is ready for a promotion. Go find him in a tavern cellar. Yup. Man, look at all these levels. You're so good at this game. Did that even work?
Yes, Captain. Captain! Mormo my
Captain!
In tavern! Mormo is cursed!
Man, he sounds really distressed. Okay, there we go. So much promotion, so little time. I'm just gonna leave them like this because it's gonna take me a while to get through all their talents and stuff. And Mormo has another quest. Oh my god! I already promoted you. I like the promotions that just take gold. You know, that makes me happy because then I can just give them gold and they're promoted. So there's that. The other thing is my pet. I'm getting a primeval dragon up to level 65. He's currently 54, so I have him equipped. And we'll be using him out for a little bit. See how good he is. He's relentless, so I think that's better than our previous pet. So yeah, a lot of like just stuff to take care of in this episode. Okay, so this first part of the recording of this power video and this part is there's like a huge space in between them because the first part I was planning on recording the entire episode, but then I got like disconnected or something. And then I just decided to not finish it at the time. So finally finishing it now, I completed a few things before starting this, the rest of this episode. And I think I got all of our companions ready to go. So that's good. And then I think I also did some side quests. So I finished that up. We don't even have the main quest because he has it right there. So let's go ahead and get our quest again.
The skyways of Mushu are polluted with the ships of outsiders. Foreign intervention has brought calamity and woe to this realm. I will not help you until you prove to me that your interests and those of Mushu are one and the same. The greatest threat to Subata is the Amber Horde. Ruthless bandits, pirates, and mercenaries, led by a barbarian named Hunan. Strike out at the ships of the Amber Horde and restore order to Subata Skyway, and I will listen to your requests.
Marking here. Okay, the Amber Horde seems to be our new enemies in this place. It's kind of funny that we had to prove ourselves to this guy even though we just took down one of the Mushu warlords. So yeah, I guess that's how it goes around here. Each skyway is kind of its own separate place. Let's head. I think I'm actually in a popular realm this time. How do I get to my ship? I think it's over here. What realm are we actually in today? I mean, Avery, yeah. I usually don't go in Avery, but for now, this is fine. Let's go and see how difficult these new pirates are. Where are they at? They're just around here. Ooh, a shadow fortress up there? Oh, there's one right here. A level 42. Actually, someone... Whoa, sorry. There's actually someone doing battle over there. That's pretty cool. It's like a frost giant with an upgrade. think he's having some trouble. I think it looks awesome. Also does a good amount of damage, so let's heal up. Already took down one of them. We're almost done with our first ship here. We had to defeat 10 of them, so... What is this guy gonna do? Don't steal my kill. Wow! Does he get the kill for that? He probably does. Okay, can't attack that one. Let's go for this one. I just used my ability, so... There we go. Pirate battles with more than... Or pirate ship battles are kind of weird with more than one person. You can just kind of just join. And it doesn't matter how much health the enemy pirate ship has. You still get the kill. But I guess it is pretty easy with like more than one person. I also wonder if there's a limit on how many people can like defeat these, or can defeat one of the pirate ships. Okay, let's continue this. Can I see what level he is? 46. My nautical level is actually 50. It's not that bad. Especially since my actual level is only 48. So there's that. Well, it looks like we're getting through these pretty quickly. I don't know how many of the Amber Horde ships this guy has left, but shouldn't take too long, so I'm gonna skip it to when we finish up 10 of these.
That'll show 'em. Let's find Lord Chagatai and see about the Scroll of Secrets.
Alright. It's kind of funny. Because while we were doing that battle, one of the enemy pirate ships just completely spawned on top of me.
I was reluctant to set another foreign vessel loose in Tsubata's skyways, but you have proven your loyalty. You may now travel throughout Tsubata with my leave. My ships will not fire upon you, so long as they are not provoked. You have come seeking access to the Scroll of Secrets. I grant you passage to the Library of Contemplation to seek it out. Librarian Quan Shi is the master there, and you must speak to him if you wish to learn how to find what you seek.
Alright, as I was saying before he interrupted me, there's like no regard to where your own ship is when the enemies spawn. They just have their set spawns, so if you're just like standing there or sailing there or whatever, it'll just completely spawn right on top of you, which is what happened. So I just thought that was kind of funny. Okay, heading up to the library, I guess. Is that on top of this hill? It's this way. I like this snowy area. There's a lot of snow here, so... kind of fits. Fits in with the winter.
There is no more for you to take.
Number what? Books? You out of books?
Oh, you are not one of them. My apologies. I mistook you for a pirate of the Amber Horde. You want to consult the Scroll of Secrets? You are out of luck. It was here, but was taken. Your only hope is Xun Zhang the Wise. Who is Xun Zhang? Well, he's wise, obviously.
Good to know.
Just ask him the rest. He's in the Temple of Eternal Serenity, atop the Great Hill. What? You are looking for our copy of the Book of Six Rings? The manual I had forgotten he had checked it out. You can find Tamazaki in the tea house.
Oh, that was my other quest.
Give you the manual.
We need to talk to him for this quest, which just gives you 3 companion points, but all right, at least we got that. So the only thing we know about this guy is that he's wise, so could be helpful, not really sure. Guess we'll find out. It's like we're climbing a whole mountain. All the way to the top, and there's probably one little temple on the top of it. Let's see, yep. There's also a Muda statue. Here's a temple. Alright, it's not really a little temple, it's kind of big. It's got its own, like, pond in here.
Say nothing. No secrets are hidden from Xunzang the Wise. I can see from your garb, you are a pirate, and you are on a quest. A quest for a missing piece of Marco Polo's map. But it was denied you, no? So now, you are here for the Scroll of Secrets. I cannot translate the markings on the pieces of the map you possess, for they are Taoist sorcery, and I am a Moodist mystic. Knowing this, you are undoubtedly lost and do not know what to do. But I will tell you because I am Xunzang the Wise. Listen. When the mountains were but hills, and the skies were still young, there was a sage, even wiser than I, Cao Tzu, father of Taoism.
Taoism?
Cao Tzu wrote the Scroll of Secrets, full of ancient wisdom. When Marco Polo came to Mushu, he studied the scroll and used it to make his map. Cao Tzu dwells upon the celestial shrine, which sits upon the back of Maruzame, the great turtle that swims the skies of the higher world. The great turtle can only be summoned to this realm by throwing 5 turtle balls into the Eye of Harmony. No small task. I, Xunzang, once visited the celestial shrine. With me were 4 heroes: Monkey King, Pigsy, Friar Sand, and Dragon Prince. These mighty heroes helped me on my journey to the West when I discovered the teachings of the Muda and brought them back to Mushu. Each of these heroes carries 1 turtle ball. The last was entrusted to me. When our great quest was done, the celestial ministers sent the heroes to watch the 4 temples of the winds. They are still guarding them. Well, all but Monkey King, who got in some trouble and forced the ministers to drop a mountain on him.
At least they didn't drop it on the shrine.
If you can get those 4 turtle balls back, I will help you find the 5th.
What do you mean find it? You're supposed to have it. Tried it?
Last I heard, Monkey King was trapped in a cavern on the Sacred Mountain, only accessible through the Temple of the South Wind. He should be so relieved to have someone to talk to that he will surrender his turtle ball without any fuss. Do not free him unless you must. I mean it. Before you go, let me give you this sealed scroll. Read it only if you set Monkey King free, and only after, no sooner.
Why does this only give 100? Okay, let's see companions here, because we get to level 49. Does he get a level? Yes.
Dragonfly, my journey is an end. Or is it a beginning? Let us go to a tavern and discuss this.
Oh my gosh. I thought his next level was going to be, or his next promotion was at 49. It's actually at 46. Okay, should we mark here? Yeah. Alright, I thought it was 49, but I guess it's 46. So, we won't be doing that right now. But we will. I will go ahead and do that in between episodes, because companion promotion quests do take a while. Where's this at? Can I just port to the Life Fountain? I think it's on a different island. Yes, it is. That's awesome. I can't wait to upgrade Camp Ho. Is anyone else? They're both 46. That's pretty good. We'll just keep Lee Bo because he's level 49. Okay, where is this at? Monkey King's Cave. Do we see it on the map? I don't see it on the map. Is it in this place? Yeah, I don't know where it is though. Oh, I think it's in the Temple of the South Wind, which he mentioned. Okay. Well, we got a lot to do, it seems, to get these four things back. And then we also have to get the fifth one back because apparently the wise Shang Tzu guy, like, hid it under a rock or something. So we need to go find that. What level are these guys? 47. It's better than the other guys were. They're only like 41, 42. Bamboo Rainbow? What? It's a weird name for a pirate ship. Okay, here we go. Crimson Dawn. Okay, into, what is this place called? South Wind? Yeah, Temple of the South Wind. Alright, I'm looking for a Monkey King, Monkey King's Cave. You know, he's supposed to be trapped under a mountain or something. But I mean, if it's a cave, then I don't really see how he's trapped. Unless he's actually in some type of cage. So to see. Okay, I think I see the cave. Cave. Can I see what level? No, you can't see what level people are unless you go in battle. Man, this place is big. This is just the sacred mountain. I feel like we're going to be spending a lot of time in this place. Just judging by the size of sacred mountain. Whoa. All I want is the Monkey King. Just give me him and we can leave. I won't have to defeat every single renegade, whoever, samurai is in here. JK would probably do that anyway. Probably be like a 6 to 10 battle dungeon in here somewhere. Those are always the best. What a journey. Check the map for this place. Oh, he's all the way in the back. Why not? Dang. It just looks like there's so much to do here. In the sacred mountain. I didn't see any like side quests yet, so maybe I just missed it. There probably is a lot of side quests here. Yes, he is in a cage. Even though it looks like he could just fit through the bars.
Ooh, have you come to set me free? Excellent. I've learned my lesson and I'm sorry for what I did. And I'm quite bored now. Do you want to leave me here, trapped in a cage, while you run away with my precious turtle ball? How inconsiderate. Let's make a deal. I'll happily surrender my turtle ball if you get me out of this cage. How does that sound? The cage key is in the keeping of Hattori Hanzo, the renowned swordsmith. His forge is on the slopes of the sacred mountain. Do not face him in open combat. Hanzo's blades are without equal. If death should face a Hanzo blade, death himself will be cut.
I would like to see that battle.
Your best bet is to take him unawares. Sneak into his shop, come up behind him, and bam! Knock him out cold.
Hattori Hanzo is a treasure of Mushu. I will not allow him to be injured.
Well, aren't you squeamish? All right, how about this? Go out in the skyway and gather up some moon pollen. Come back to Hamzo's and offer to have tea with him. Put the pollen in his tea. Hanzo takes a nap,
You take the key, everybody wins.
Oh my. He's in the cage. He's basically a prisoner. We could just... I feel like we could, like, just take the turtle ball. But that would be too easy. That would be far too easy. Okay, we have to go to... Should I mark here? We're not going to mark here yet. So we have to go get the guy with the... With the, whatever, the key. Before we can go back to the monkey guy. Next time we have to go back to the monkey eye, I'm probably going to skip that, because that took forever to walk there. Wow, this is really far away. 8,000 away for pollen? Okay, this should be the last one. Finally.
I don't feel good about this plan, and I wouldn't trust Monkey King further than I could throw him.
This place is so far away that the numbers were going off of the quest arrow. Alright, we finally made it. Here, there's this forge, and here's this little hut. Let's go talk to him.
I do not think I will take my tea just yet. There is something sour about the tea that might disagree with me. Oh, did you think I would not see through your little scheme? Did you think that you are the first the Monkey King has sent? There is no key to the Monkey King's cage. I built a lock with no key to taunt him. It seems to have worked quite well. Tell the Monkey King that there will be no clever escape this time. He must serve his full sentence. 10,000 years.
Wait, what did he do again? I don't even know what the monkey did. Maybe it wasn't his turtle ball to begin with. Or he stole something else that was sacred. Probably. Let's go talk to him again. We're definitely leaving a mark by the monkey. For future references. Because it seems like we're going to be coming back here a lot. Hopefully we get this XP. That would be awesome. Not that I would level or anything. Because we still are... We like just leveled. But still. That's like half almost. Not bad. I think I got some new badges this episode too. May look at those. And then in between this episode... Can Po will get his promotion. So that'll be exciting.
What? There is no key? This is an outrage. If there's no way to open the lock, then I must bash the bars apart. If only I had my golden staff, that would do it. My golden staff was taken from me by the Dragon King long ago when they put me in here. He can't still be mad, can he? If you can fetch me back my golden staff and help me get out of this cage, I'll get you your turtle ball and help you out. The Dragon King's realm is at the bottom of the Lake of the Rising Sun. Just jump in and swim. You'll find it. Tell him you want the challenge.
The challenge. Not just any challenge. You know, the best thing I could tell him is just to, you know, squeeze through right there. Yeah, that would do it. But no, maybe there's a magical barrier or something. Okay, so we gotta collect his golden staff. So we'll head over to the dragon guy next time. That'll be exciting. We'll get Kanpo up to Goat Master. He's currently a Goat Disciple, so next he'll become the Master himself. So that'll be exciting stuff. I'm pretty hyped about this quest line with these four heroes that we have to help to get these turtle balls. So exciting stuff. Stay tuned for next time and all of that. Make sure you like the video if you enjoyed it, and I will see you all next time.